You're hungover. I am not surprised, to be honest with you. You drank a lot last night. Like, I think you had like 17 or 18 shots. Pretty unbelievable for you. I've always considered you kind of a lightweight, so I'm not surprised that you're feeling the consequences of last night. It was really fun though, wasn't it? Yeah, I really enjoyed myself too. Thanks for staying safe. Sleeping over, not driving when you were so drunk. Seriously, you were blacked out last night. I don't think I've ever seen you quite like that. It was pretty funny. Oh. Just made a fresh pot. I can go grab you a cup. Okay, one second. I'll get you some coffee. Here's yours. You want me to just set it here for you? Okay. Are you feeling nauseous at all? A little bit. When I'm feeling nauseous, I like to practice this breathing exercise. You hold one nostril in and breathe. And then you plug the other one and breathe out. And in. And usually if I do that for a long enough time, I start to feel better. Oh, no, it's fine. I don't want you to feel bad for being hungover. I honestly don't mind taking care of you. I kind of hoped that you would end up staying over, to be honest with you. Honestly, I mean it. Why? Well, let's just say that ever since we met a couple months ago, I've been increasingly enjoying your company. Except when you're blacked out and yelling at everyone. No, the real you is sweet and kind and really, really funny. The drunk you is pretty funny too, though, I will say. You're pretty hilarious when you're drunk. Hangovers aren't quite as funny, though, are they? Mm-mm. Maybe you could take like an hour, 2 hour nap before we go out for lunch. If you want to, of course. I didn't know if you had anything to do for the rest of the day. But we could definitely go grab lunch a little later if you're interested. Okay, cool. Do you have anything in mind? I know you're kind of nauseous right now, but I could go for some pizza, personally. How does pizza sound? No? Oh, okay, don't throw up. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I brought it up. Please don't throw up. At least not over here. There's a trash can, like, right over there, or the bathroom is that way. I'm sure you know you seem. No, don't worry. I already cleaned it all up. It's okay. Yeah, you did leave quite a mess in there, but it's totally fine. I don't mind cleaning up after you. I mean, I would do it for anyone. I'm a good friend. I mean, I try my hardest to be. But you're a special guest. What do you remember? I know you said a little bit. Oh, yeah, that was pretty early in the evening. Do you want me to tell you what you did? So, after we were at the first bar, we went to Bucking Lucy's. And you tried to ride the mechanical bull. Yeah. Oh, I know. I know you're not coordinated enough to do that. I tried to tell you that last night, but you didn't want to listen to anybody. So we had to let you do it. And let's just say you didn't last up there for very long before getting bucked. I guess that's why they call it Bucking Lucy's, but yeah, I think that's why you have that big bruise on your arm. I think that's where you fell off the mechanical bull. You are too funny for that one. Honestly, it was pretty hilarious, but I also felt bad because we all knew you were gonna fall off, and we tried to warn you not to go up there, but you did it anyways. Yeah, you're pretty stubborn when you've had that much to drink. I am really excited to have you back in town. You're honestly one of my favorite people to hang out with. You're just a really fun time. I'm sure the hangover will pass really, really soon. Yeah. Do you want me to help you drink your coffee? Sure. Here. Take a sip. It's pretty hot. Are you excited for tonight? Yeah, I tried to tell you that this is the actual event, but you just decided to go super hard at the pre-party. I don't know why. Oh my god, you are too cute. I know. You probably feel disgusting right now after all of those drinks. And throwing up and borderline peeing your pants in the back of the Uber. Hitting on this girl, and I think that's when I realized that I liked you a little bit, because I started to get kind of jealous. Although I guess I shouldn't be jealous, because whose house did you end up at? Mine. Speaking of which, do you need anything else? A blanket? Yeah, are you cold? You have those weird hangover chills. I totally understand. Here, let me get you a blanket. Okay. Just gonna slide over here. And do you want me to wrap this around you? Okay, here. Does that feel better? The blanket is super fluffy, so I hope you feel nice and warm. Yeah, it's no problem. Well, to be honest, I do have so we are gonna need to kind of speed up your rehabilitation a little bit. You're welcome to come over later. Or you can stay here and sleep if you really need to. I trust you in my house by yourself. Make sure you don't go through my drawers or anything, though. I'm glad we got to reconnect. Yeah, we had a little bit of a falling out, but that's mainly because you stopped texting me back. So technically, we didn't have a falling out. You decided you didn't want to talk to me anymore, and then randomly decided you did. Ain't that something? Yeah. I am gonna have to get to work here pretty soon, though. So, I'm gonna have to leave you for a little bit. But I will be back later tonight, around like 7:30 or 8. So, if you wanted to do something, do you want to get lunch? Yeah, we should probably leave here pretty soon before traffic gets bad. You're so cute. I'm serious. I really do have just a tiny crush on you. Serious, nothing major, but I don't know, there's just something about you in your helpless hangover What was your favorite part about this weekend? Hanging out with me. That was my favorite part too, except hanging out. Seriously, like, I need you here. I miss you every time that you leave. Yeah, I probably should have realized that I had a crush on you when I started feeling that way. Started to miss you a lot when you would leave me. Pretty silly. The way you look, your personality is something that you just can't stop thinking about. You have a heart of gold. Honestly, anyone would be lucky to be with you. I'm serious. Never seen you drink that much in my life. You feel nervous around me. Why? I'm like the sweetest, kindest, funniest, most innocent girl that there's possibly ever been. Oh, nonsense. I cannot even handle it. Does this feel good? Yeah. Good. I could sit here and do this all day long if you wanted me to. After lunch, of course, and work. So all night long, I guess I should. Are you feeling any better? Just a little. Okay, good. I'm really sorry that you have such a bad hangover. Yeah, I don't really have like Advil or anything. I'm sorry. Just gotta tough it out. So glad that I convinced you to get an Uber with me. I was really worried about you last night. Yeah, I've seriously never seen you that intoxicated before. You were falling over yourself. I had to keep picking you up, and I don't know if you've seen how small I am. Yeah, I genuinely have no idea how I got you on your feet. Multiple times. You're pretty lucky I was looking out for you. Make sure no creeps came and got you. No weirdos. Can't have that. Oh, safe and everything is okay. Just try to relax. Try to relax. Calm your mind. Come back to your breath in and out. Save your troubles for another day. Today is not the day to worry. Nope, no worries. All you need to do is just relax. Yeah. You deserve to relax. What are you talking about? You deserve it. Seriously. You deserve to. It's a beautiful day outside. We could go sit in the sun. That always helps me with my hangover. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can come with you for a little bit after lunch, but then I have to get to work, remember? Yeah, I wish I could stay longer. Hanging out with you is super enjoyable. I find. Well, thanks for being here with me. Relax. 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 Take a deep breath in. It's a secret ancient remedy. Yeah. You just make some magic and then blow it on to the person who's not feeling well. And the thing about magic is it knows exactly what is out of alignment and it finds its way into those little nooks and crannies and fixes it, makes minor adjustments, and suddenly everything is all better. You are so adorable. Honestly, one of the funniest people I've ever met in my life. I'm so glad that you're here. If you ever no one ever deserves to be by themselves when they're not feeling good.